Lights out and away we go. From Mexico, King Ting on pole. Pastore in second, Pagani third. You've got Lennon in fifth. Allo off the slow, really slow stop. I don't know, Osignola's taking my car again. Oh, there's been a collision! Oh, I can't believe that. That was Williams. Allo, he's just dropped back down to sixth. Eighth. Look, it's in front of Selby in fifth place, Lennon in fourth. Selby sixth place. Popstar Andy in front of third. No excuses if McLaren don't take this. Because Allo's on his own. Great move. Popstar Andy and Pagani coming at it. Lennon and Luke here in the McLaren's needing to get past. Oh, he's gone wide. He's got to be careful coming back on. Selby's past and so is Luke. Shockwave retires again. He's out. Now, the American's got a lot to do to get past these guys because it is Renault versus McLaren. Now, Osignolas has taken Selby's car, which means a ban is coming his way very soon. Randy, oh, he's overshot a little bit, but that is a great overtake. Gets over the curve, gets on the inside and into fifth, Munro seventh. Looking good so far. The safety car then come out. This could end really quickly, and Keating is having a smashing start to this race on pole. King, you're happy? It's good. Keep it up. Only world champions here win races now. It's been a long time and Pagani won the 100% Baku. Allo keeps on winning the 50s and King Ting dominating the 25s. This is not, it's not exactly going to plan for anyone on the grid if they are to try and compete. Greeny LFC on his second appearance to try and beat the grid. Is he good enough? Lacey bigged him up. He raced in TARDIS' lead, but that is a lead way off the pace. Way off the standard. You know, for Lacey to start at the back of Wacko in the Tutelar roster, to win this race now is as hard as winning at Stoke City on a rainy night. It's not going to happen. Luke on the inside in fifth. Good move to little action so far. Looks like Selby trying to get past it. Osignola's getting closer in that Renault. That's my car. I don't want to get a pen because I know Mexico, everyone racks them up.
Conditions still remain dry for a while. We will update you if the outlook changes.
Luke's gone wide. Start to lose concentration now, Luke. What a race so far we're having.
You'll be on the softs. We're considering switching.
DRS enabled. Osignola is getting closer on the straight. And that 4 of 36, 32 to go till the end of the night. Racing finishes at midnight with 30 minutes left of this race. It's definitely going to finish on time as scheduled. King Ting's currently leading this Grand Prix. Hasn't won for quite a while, King Ting. He could literally set it alight in this 50% if he does get this race win. Deserves it big time. He probably would have rather the special in the Ayrton Senna go ahead tonight because his connection looks better. So is Selby's. And Alas, they've sorted their connection out for tonight. All three of them. Probably should have held that off for tonight. Well, you know, the curse of the commentator could come to haunt them. Jack Lacey up to 8th. Lacey from 19 up to 8th place. Oh! Allo is lost connection. Selby's cursed him. Selby curses Allo in one of the most crucial races he's ever going to compete in, because he's definitely going for the Constructors. Pagani's coming to the pit. Selby's still running. He's gone 6th place now. This is not over just yet. Where is Kojak? Because Lacey's come from the back all the way to 7th. He is doing the impossible. Lacey, quick question. Can you get past me and Ozaniales? Two drivers you're not really scared of, are you? Oh, Lennon's gone. Lennon is out of the race. It looks like he's got to spin this one round. Lacey can't quite believe what he is seeing on his screen here tonight. Can't believe what he's seeing. And he is just jumping position after position. Let's look at Ozaniales and Selby's career on F1 for the last couple of years. We've seen Lacey do it before, and I don't think he's going to be hanging around these two for any longer than 2 laps. He's definitely going to get past them both. Lacey's into 5th, Kington still leading the Grand Prix. Now, when it comes to pace, Lacey's just a little bit faster than Kington, just a little, not too much, but it's tyre management now, and DRS. If Selby can get past with DRS, this is not good news for Lacey. And Selby does like to overshoot quite a lot, he really does. Holds off for now. 30 to go. Wocco up to 7th place. These Toro Rossos are not fucking around, man. I'm joking. I don't know where they come out from, but they've come from last place up to 5th and 7th. Wocco was smashing that time, and he's putting pressure on Selby now. Sherman, how's it going in the McLaren? I want some info. What is going down in that garage? Because Allo is now out and hasn't even got an invite to get back in, I don't think. Wocco. Oh, no! No! He's got into me. I was nowhere near him.
Are you all right? Engine off.
Oh, my God. I was nowhere near him. Wocco, he turned into me and I couldn't go anywhere. Star Andy leaving Grand Prix. Let's have a look at this. He survived. I didn't survive. So he survived the collision, Wocco, with a front wing damage. He's got to come in and safety car now. To pick up Selby's car. Thank you. I've not had a crash for a long time. Why is this game? Rambo Killer is sick, and we just turned track racing. Fourth place. What a Grand Prix! And Selfie's out, so he's on the commentary now. You can see from the video of this racing, we can now start getting on board with a lot of drivers to try to get some seriously good action. It's a great challenge. Car out in Mexico for this 50%. Popstar Randy leading the Grand Prix, Kochat second, Kington third, Ozzignano's in fourth, Jack Lacey fifth, Rambo Killer sixth, Pagani seventh, Marmon eighth, Sherman ninth, and Allo is tenth. After losing connection, Lucas 11th, he needs to start getting in the points to help McLaren out here. This is now a dogfight. It looks like ultimate stand DQ, Shockwave retirement, Selby retirement, and that's about it. You can see the McLaren team out of the points there on the screen. So nothing happening in terms of closing the gap on the wings. Get on board with it. What was the race leader, Kington now in third. Ozzignano behind him, Kochak in second, Popstar Andy in first. So far so good. Well, while the safety car is out, nothing much is happening. We've run you down with the grid. This is going to be an absolutely brilliant restart. Lap 9, safety car out, the shoe off the brake. Don't go anywhere. Racing, lights out, the safety car's come back in. This is on Kington here, we're on board. So you've joined us back with Popstar Andy leading the Grand Prix and Kington in third. This is a great view, I love this. Board of Ian here running down at the back of 50. Oh, nothing going on. Waco trying to get a move here on there. Oh, He's got to go for a move. It's gone ball was showing in the McLaren. He's in 10th. McLaren team having a terrible, terrible race in Mexico. They need to get in the points. And they've got Allo right in front of them. He's holding them up. Brilliant. Exciting race, Luke. In 8. Here we go. So, here's Luke. Brilliant. Get on board with Mummer here, looking for a move on the straight. See if he gets DRS it. And again, it looks like Pagani's come in. It's gotta be him in the pits. Let's check this out. He is. It's a drive-through. And there you see him coming through. Oh my word, 14th. And what a night he's having. Absolutely terrible. Last in USA. And again, he's down at the back in Mexico. What is going on? On board with Greeny here. Greeny LSC. Oh, look at the land. This guy's not being. Very promising, Green. Good. He's making his way through the grid. Up next is Mum and Luke Cleary in 6. He's higher. 5 race wins in a row, looking to make it 6 for the second time in this championship. Going for the move on Mumrum on the inside here. He's got to watch Luke. He's having a break himself. He's got it. Great move from the world champion. Brilliant stuff. Really looking to kick on here for 6 race wins in a row, Allo. He's still got time to do it. He's done it before midway from Spain, Monaco, Canada, Azerbaijan, Austria and Great Britain. And then he went on a drought before going back on another run from Italy onwards. This is a brilliant race. Greeny has retired and there's Allo on the outside of blue. He's got him. Brilliant move. He doesn't give up, Luke, does he? Manages to fight his way back in front of him in his 6th. And Allo is a very safe driver. Doesn't take risks. He doesn't gamble. And that's why he is the way he is. He just hardly ever is involved in incidents. He's never had a complaint to him. Quite incredible, doesn't get penalties. Allo kick on with these guys battling wheel to wheel. This is not great for them because he's coming. So the big coming from behind. He's getting close up. They've been so high in demand this championship. And given the circumstances that they're battling for the Constructors' title, that is something else. Something else. Unbelievable. is in front of all three McLarens now. But it 10 points playing Luke, Lennon and Schoen in 6, 7 and 9, I think it is. I've got to move on the outside here, Luke. Get back on board with this. Cuts on the inside. Oh no, there's a collision. Kojak in the middle of this. This is so close. Unbelievable Grand Prix. Just look how close this is. And Ano's gone off. Oh. Back on board with this guy. He's just literally in. Having to go wheel to wheel with so many drivers here. He's down in eighth now, battling his way through. Lennon on the inside, Rocco in sixth place. Rocco overshooting slightly. Right corner cut there, Rocco's got to concede here. Lennon on the outside. Can Allo take advantage? Showing them one of them just bearing down on them. This is incredible. Let's have a look at this. Goes for the inside, Allo! Wow! Has he got this move or what? He's checking it. Mumma on the outside. Look, he's come through Lennon. What a Grand Prix this is. Wheel to wheel. Just exchange after exchange. There's a Renault in the background. Looks like Osignales, no? It is Osignales, the Dutchman. Get back on board with Rocco here, going wheel to wheel. Still with one room, Allo in behind, showing in ninth place, and Lennon in fifth. One of the best Grand Prix we've seen all season. This is incredible. Well, watch this, it's 20 laps to go. It's as clean as you ever can get. Teammate Luke in fourth, and you've got Rocco sixth, Mumma seventh, Allo's been pegged back down to eighth place. This is the battle we're on board with, because the wheel to wheel has been something else, quality at best. This is a great watch over the Christmas period for wheel users. It's just about in front in third. Just about missing the action. Mambo Killer, one of his best starts in Grand Prix so far. He's running the second. Lacey has got from last all the way to first. What a Grand Prix he's having, that to our Rosso. From last place on the grid on qualification, and Rambo in second, finding the pressure on. Safety car has come out after Kojak leaving, I think. Oh, is it because of yours? What happened? I missed it. You're kidding me. So I completely missed that. I went on board with Kington and then followed on with Jack Lacey. That was seriously close racing. I mean, Lennon, that was really good going wheel to wheel with Rocco, Mumma, Allo, and then your teammate Luke in front. That is a shame, because McLaren needed every point. They needed every point, and you've managed to retire out of this. This is just literally handing the constructors on the plate to Allo at the minute. But you've got to look at it in this sense. Kojak retires, Selby retires, Pagani drives through, and then Lennon's out. So if you're Allo, you can pretty much clean this up. We'll have a look at it afterwards and we'll see it. Only time will tell what that's done to the Constructors' Championship. But Popstar Andy did get 5th in that last race, while Munman took 6th. He's had a good night, Munman. He's had a great night. Yeah, it is. Oh, Rambo Killer's got a drive through. Wow. Back with the action. We'll come back from another break with 2 safety cars again in this race. Incredible stuff. Something else, this is. Yeah, I have. Yeah, I've got it. Quality, really, really good. I missed your refresh. Just gonna get on. Look how much debris is on track. I mean, man. Montagnoli is still in third place here. Wocco running in third after that wing change and that collision with Selby. That was not a cool collision. Selby not a happy driver, but it's happened now. King Ting leading the Grand Prix back in front. He's just doing everything right, King Ting, the world champion, to win this. Just the same as Allo done in the last race. King Ting is about your only driver who's going to be able to win some races against Allo. So you've got Lennon, Jack Lacey, possibly Kojak, and King Ting, who can really put up a fight against this guy when it comes to victories. But Pagani and Schoen are your best drivers when it comes to second and third place finishes in the podium. It's been a good race for King Ting. I mean, this is long time coming. What a race he's having. He had overtaken the night the other week. He's leading this Grand Prix in this 50%. Lap 21 and 36, not long to go. His only threat now is that Allo has got closer, because he was 8th, he's now 4th. And now that the group is closed, this guy's pace is gonna do damage to King Ting's Grand Prix now. He's won what? Oh my God, see that? bad night for Renault. What's that? Oh, did he? Just missed that. 1 sec. Sorry. Oh, he's gone wide. He's gone down to third. King Team, what has he done? Conceding the lead. I just can't believe this, huh? Wacko, out of all drivers, is leading the Grand Prix. And what looked to be down and out and a write-off with the collision with Selby, look at where he is now. Lap 22, he leads the Grand Prix, and Selby sitting on the sideline commentating on this race. It's quite incredible what can happen on a night like this. And he quite easily was so close to a write-off. And look at this. This is just incredible. You don't write this stuff. Ian is now down at the back in 14th, really struggling to get into points. If you look at Greeny here, he's also struggling to even find his feet in Selby GP. He's out of his depth. He's out of his depth. He's not as good as he thought he is. Selby GP is a different level. And he hasn't even met my tier two. And have a look at showing the Munro going wheel to wheel. Pagani's got into the points in 10th. This is a good battle head down at the back. Just going to stay on board with this one. Showing in 8th. Oh, this is so closed out, man. Just looking at Jack Lacey. He's now down into 7th. And his teammate currently leads the Grand Prix. Wacko. Driver 2. And Toro Rosso. He's not that far in front, let's be honest. Allo, I think, is still in fourth. He's not gained. He's just in behind Rambo Killer, who has to come in for a drive for Ratty. So he's still yet to come in. Has he come in? It's impossible, because he wouldn't be second, would he? Popstar Randy, sixth place. Luke in fifth. Not too bad. Don't want to lose Sal, man, on a crash here. Get on Luke Fury. He's on the outside here, and he doesn't want to turn into that car. There you go. The American just in front. Steady. Does it. I think he's going to hit. Rambo Killer comes in for his drive-through, just like Selby did say. He's in for the drive-through. Let's get the camera view of this race. The outside on Allo. Look at this, he's just competing with the best here at the front, and showing he's not that far behind him. He's definitely got to follow in his footsteps. It's Lacey going wheel to wheel. What a driver. Sensational. Oh, no, he's running wide. Luke's running wide. Rambo Killer's retired. That drive for everything's done it. Gone. Oh, King Ting's about to get overtaken here by Popstar Randy. Good move around the outside. It was easy with DRS into second. King Ting now down into third. Wacko lead in the Grand Prix. Has he? Wow. Are you kidding me? So Lucas has got past the Williams. Formidable world champion. Double world champion. Oh, and there's the contact between Lacey and Allo. This is Sterling Moss and Fangio with these two unbelievable racers, and showing just in the background watching this. Let's get a close up of their car. That was the slightest of contacts, but nothing major. They still running fifth and sixth, and in behind them is that McLaren, showing still in that top 10. Let's get a ride with Pagani. Who's that? Yeah, it is. Rocco Pub and Ting Ting. Let's get on board with this, dude. Wheel to wheel between these two Ferraris on the track. Oh my word, Rocco in trouble here on the straight against DRS by the American, going round the outside like he did it against King Ting. He looks good, but look, King Ting coming back on the inside. This is incredible stuff. King Ting is going to hold on both of them. What a race this is. And Rocco trying to hang in there on the inside of Pop Star Andy. He can't hold him off. He's got to give him room. Sensational helicopter view. Wow, what a race. Watch it back. It's no boring race. This is sensational stuff. Oh no, they're gonna collide again. That helicopter view. And he's running. Well, he's conceded. I think he had to let him back because of an illegal overtake. Look at this, invites the Mercedes in. He's inviting the Mercedes right now, so he doesn't want to clip him. He has! What goes in the wall? The slightest of contacts! Oh my word! He will watch the replays! Helicopter view catches it! I've got it! Oh my god! Unbelievable! That's a racing incident. Who was in the Mercedes? That's bad, man. Helicopter view of Luke hitting Walker into the wall. I don't think it's in tip, but still, man, you know, you've got to be sure that that car's fully in front before you turn. It's a tough one. I think it was. My helicopter view, you'll see it. Well, Allo's now fourth. Jack Lacey going back up to fifth place here, showing in sixth. He basically did exactly the same as what he did to Wood. King Ting leading the Grand Prix here on lap 28 of 36. Let's have a look at Schoen here. Aaron. Getting closer to Jack Lacey with DRS. Good couple of points, Luke in front of him. Lacey now should get DRS on him. Goes to the defensive. Sensational. He's been done over into the podium position. Allo goes third. It's a phenomenal Grand Prix. Absolutely sensational. wheel with Lacey now. Looks like Luke is going wheel to wheel with Lacey again. Is he running wide? Let's have a look. No, he didn't. Still watching it again. No, he's cut the screen. Lacey's got to watch out here. Luke Fury and Jack Lacey. Might not get DRS here, but still holding on. Anno in third place. Has he got the pace though, Luke? Has he got the pace? Oh no, he's off! Luke is out! Luke is out! Good night! Game over for Luke! He spun it! Oh, are you kidding me? I just caught the end of that. I didn't catch it. Oh. Wow, incident again, and that looks like Luke's race is over now. He went for the overtake, but Lacey went for the defence, I think. And there you go. I'm guessing he probably would have gone a bit aggressive on him, I don't know why. Well, we'll see it anyway, but I did catch him right at the end of it when he started weaving and smashing some wall. Yes, Alo and Masquerade getting very close to pop star Andy. Aim retires. Back to like 30 or 36. 10 past midnight. Pop star Andy still looking for a podium here tonight. Easy for the light. Alan's got the move, but Popstar Andy back on his inside. Again with a helicopter view. He still leads your Grand Prix. This is going to be one of his best victories in Selby GP. He is. He's doing world class tonight. Qualified pole, and it looks like he's going to get the race win. It's all about whether he can hold off Alo and Masquerade, because he has got past Popstar Andy. So this is the race we want to stay on board with. This is it, Kington just in front. About holding on to him, you know. 4 laps to go, come on. Excellent action at the back of Kozak, still running in the 10th for Renault. At some point, Mumma comes into the pits, he looks like he's changed tyres. Pagani in 6th place, looking good for Renault. And Lacey in 4th. Alo. It's getting closer to Kington. This is the fight. Popstar Andy putting some pressure on. This is outrageous, man. Blue flags are out anyway, but they're already past. But this is basically what Kington needs. He needs Popstar Andy to get the DRS and get past Alo and hold him up for a little bit. But that's not happening at the minute. He's going to have to defend. He's going to have to defend against Alo on the last couple of laps, but how he's going to do it now, he's closed in within a second, I don't know. And Alo looking for his sixth race win in a row. Oh, think he's a good defender. Oh, he looks up for the defence. No, he's not. He's going to get it right on the outside. Allo's gone through into first place. Kington can't do anything about it. I can't believe it. Allo, the most patient driver on the grid. Oh, my words. He's gone a little bit wide now. He's got to fight against Protocol Andy. On board with Kington, he's now dropped down to third. He just can't hang in there. Three to go. Pop Star Randy has gone back into second. Allo now leads with 25 points again. He is doing everything needed for the Constructors' title. Whether it's going to be mathematically possible for Renault and McLaren after this, I don't know. The two races to go, they're going to be barring miracles shortly. This guy just doesn't retire, does he? He retired on the one night where it was a full house and couldn't get back in the lobby. No, it wasn't that, actually. He just retired on the only night where it was a full house, and that was Belgium. And all the other Grand Prix is finished for him. We'll have a look. We'll see. We'll see very soon. The DRS is enabled, so Kington is going to get a little bit closer on it. Wheel to wheel. Pops there. Renzi's gone for the move. He's not shy of a late dive, Popstar Radley, but he's very good when it comes to timing. I nearly got it. On the races of the season, Popstar Radley's still pushing. Let's have a look at anything that's happening at the back. Let's get off this one for a while. Allo just defending Popstar Randy. Let's just see it on the straight. We'll get on board with someone else just behind. Yeah, let's get on board with another McLaren driver. That's Schoen down in fifth place. So Schoen is battling Lacey, and Popstar Randy is battling Allo, a mass player. He's got DRS now. Can Schoen get the move on Lacey on the outside? You can't make too many defensive moves. Lacey knows that. You're not allowed to do that. You can't go left and right. You've got to only go for one defensive move. I need to message that now. Oh my God, he's retired. What's happened at the front? No way. Are you kidding me? You have got to be kidding me. On the last two laps, Popstar Randy is out, and I've completely missed it, staying on board the show. And Kington now in second, and Allo and Mass Player looking for six in a row. The German is gonna win Mexico. One lap to go. What happened, Popstar? What's going through your mind right now? Because you must be one of the most angriest Americans right now. That was a very, very good podium if you got it, Popstar. That would have been world class. How close were you to that win, man? Well, there's Allo looking for another race win, and it looks like it's going to be six. Just on board with him at the minute. Let's go with Kojak in 11th. He's struggling for Renault. Greeny LFC down in 10th. Osignola's 8th. And then you've got Mumrum in 7th place. Lucchiri 6th. Pagani 5th. Lacey 4th. Schoen's gone into 3rd place. Schoen out of nowhere. to third. But Allo is going to cross the line for Williams and make it six race wins in a row. One tonight in USA, one again here in Mexico. He's done it again. Unbelievable performance. Ting Ting has been picked right at the end. What a Grand Prix. What a Grand Prix this has been. Pagani will score. I just about missed that. Lacey. I caught the helicopter view of Waco and Luke, and then I just about missed you and Luke going head to head on the straight. Now, I don't know whether you weaved or if you went for two defensive moves. Nah, come on. But you can't play like that. You've got to play your own game, Lacey, man. I know what you're thinking, but still, he's not a bad driver. He just catches the back end of people. He's done it on Woods. He's done it on Greeny. He's done it again. He just needs to stop moving into position until the car's fully in. Not you. I'm talking about Luke. Yeah, but you can't take it into your hands and say, you know what, I'm going to make life difficult for him. But, you know, I didn't really catch it, but apparently he was weaving. I don't know what happened, really. If it's one, then you've done nothing wrong. I guess you've done nothing wrong, yeah, that's it. I don't know what Lennon was on about, so I didn't catch it. Anyway, the thing with Waco, I caught it helicopter view. You'll see it. I'm telling you, you'll see it when I post it up. It was definitely a racing incident, though.
Wow, Matt. Bro, there's one shot in hell.
Well, that is it.
Okay.
That is it for tonight. Allo does the double.
Come on, get the ball.
And six in a row in this championship. He's not just won the world championship, but he is closing in for the constructors. That is it. We'll see you again very soon.
Blue, 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 they're blue. They're blue.